Happy Women's Equality Day. Women's Equality Day is celebrated on August 26th, and it's commemorating the passage of the women's suffrage right to vote in the U.S., the 19th Amendment. It was first celebrated in 1971, and this celebration is just a reminder for us of the challenges that women faced with violence and discrimination in an effort to push the women's movement forward. The 19th Amendment prohibits the states and the federal government from denying the right to vote to citizens on the basis of sex. In my celebration of this day, I want to lift up the memory of the Black woman who worked hard and holistically within the suffragist movement. In spite of their invisibility and their lack of historical acknowledgement, Black women played an active role in the struggle for a woman's right to vote. They participated at all levels, in meetings and marches, in organized political societies, policy conversations, and although they might have been selectively left out or not heard, they were there. And many outspoken Black suffragists were critical of the 15th Amendment and that it provided enfranchisement for Black men, but not for women. But we've always worked within larger movements, more holistically, not from the perspective of individual rights as much as from the perspective of the race, the community, and the family. By the 1890s, the women's suffrage movement had become increasingly racist and exclusive. Some of the prominent white suffragists questioned whether Black women were a liability to the cause. There was this segregated political activism as Black and white women, they organized separately due to class and racial tensions within the overall movement. And we've always done that. We can look to the feminist. So like always, when we're not really heard at the table or even invited to the table, we create our own table. And so Black women organized separately. They formed clubs and organizations where they could focus on the issues that affected them. Those things that would uplift the race, the community, and the family, and that trickles down to the individual. So my grandmother belonged to one of the colored women's clubs that were started out of the in the 1890s. So with some of the work that was done in the colored women's clubs, women won the vote in dozens of states in the 1910s, and African-American women became a powerful voting bloc. We still are. Remember Georgia? So in celebration, I just want to lift up a couple Black women's names. Ida B. Wells is one of them. And in 1913, the Alpha Suffrage Club was founded, and Ida B. Wells was one of the co-founders, and it's believed to be the first African-American Women's Suffrage Association in the U.S. And they worked in publishing a newspaper, the Alpha Suffrage Record, that would really go out in neighborhoods and to voice political opinions. Now, most of us have heard of Ida B. Wells, but someone a little less well-known is Nannie Helen Burroughs. And she was a Black educator, orator, religious leader. She was a feminist and a businesswoman in the U.S., and her speech, How the Sisters Are Hindered from Helping, was given at the 1900 National Baptist Convention in Virginia, and was incredibly well received. We're still asking that question, you know, how the sisters are hindered from helping in the movement, whatever the movement might be. And Dr. Burroughs, her main objective was pointing out the intersections between race and gender, and she really fought for equal rights, and she really tried to further opportunities for women beyond the simple duties of domestic chores. So sadly, women aren't done fighting for equal rights. Today, the wage gap between men and women still impacts women's economic power, and gender-based discrimination still affects workplaces and business transactions. And although the pay gap is narrowing, women in the U.S. working full and part-time still make 85% of what their male counterparts make. And Black women have to work 19 months to make what white men earn in a year, and this is according to the National Women's Law Center. But there are a few other areas where there's still work to do. Women are also the minority in the news sector, in the tech sector, in the executive suite, and in our government. And of course, we live longer and we make less, but retired women are twice as likely as retired men to live in poverty. And according to the World Economic Forum 2021 gender gap report, it's going to take about 135 years for countries to close the gender gap. Now, sadly, I won't be around. But I'll tell you what's even sadder is that my granddaughters won't see this happen in their lifetime with those projections. And now, I don't want to be a complete downer. So, happy